Right, ladies and gentlemen, I thank FISME for giving me this opportunity to speak over here. And as far as Hyderabad is concerned, I'm coming after 2 years approximately to give a talk to the medium and small scale industries. The key messages which I would like to convey during the talk is that there is an expenditure, ever rising expenditure, which on defense and aerospace. Not only defense and aerospace, but also in the adjacent markets, which go or which have a similarity along with the defense and aerospace sector. For example, the aviation sector and the homeland security sector. So there are a lot of things which are common, and this commonality gives us new opportunities which I will elaborate during the talk. Definitely, MSMEs have an opportunity to outsource from the services that we use. Directly to the services, what I mean is the airport, the navy and the army, and also to the DPSUs and the ordnance practitioners. But however, there are other opportunities also, which because of the growing aviation demand. So therefore, opportunities exist with DPSUs, definitely, and ordnance factory board. I won't cover that right now, because I'm sure when it comes to the DPSUs who are going to give a talk later on, they're going to cover all the avenues of what their outsource or what they intend to outsource. Then, directorates of indigenization have been set up at each service headquarter level. That is for the Air Force, Army and Navy. And this is basically to indigenize the spares which we are importing. So it's part of the revenue procurement. We call it, it's with the workshops as far as the Army is concerned or the Navy is concerned. As far as the Navy is concerned, we have a batch of indigenization set up at Gujarat, and then there is one at Vizag. As far as the Army is concerned, the various workshops have been given the task of indigenization. And as far as the Air Force concerned, it is a base effort repair depot or the BRDs, and they have their own tendering procedure. This also will be covered later on, so I won't go into depth right now. Then there are the large industries who are getting a majority of the offsets right now. And they are also trying to get in and into projects directly. So there are problems and challenges which we see. But then indigenization is on the increase, not at the pace at which we would like it to happen, but yes, very slowly. So are the opportunities only this much for medicine, or is there something else? I would just like to briefly touch on the aviation market. Now, civil aviation market or the products have also been allowed in offsets as far as DPP level is concerned. And this fleet size is growing. The extent to which it is growing, you can see, we feel that the amount of commercial aircraft will rise from 358 today to 980 in 2020. So that doesn't mean that the Asia Pacific region or China are not growing, they are also growing as far as the fleet size is concerned. But the pace at which we are growing is much faster. And we are the 9th largest aviation market in the world. And the passenger traffic has grown, and so has cargo traffic. And this has been the main driver by the fleet size is growing. So therefore, as far as aviation is concerned, because there is a growth in air traffic, because the manpower cost arbitrage is low in India, because of the fleet size increases, government initiatives are there, and coming to the civil aviation fleet also. And then from the other side, because of the cost cutting all over the world, as far as the aviation market is concerned, the OEMs are looking for cost cutting measures for manufacturing, for MRO, or for training. So when the fleet size grows, the aviation market grows, therefore the adjacent services which are concerned with the aviation market, for example, the MRO, the training, even which have come to India in 2010, this is the highest in the world. Similarly, the MRO market is set to grow. And the MRO market, whether it's the defense or civil aviation, is again interrelated. And therefore, a large third party MRO service providers coming into the picture. And right now, I would count them as a medium scale industry. But there's an opportunity, and people are looking to be the first, if not easier to get in. The MRO market is huge, not only for the commercial market of aircraft sales, but also for the general aircraft sales. By general aircraft, I mean the business jets and the helicopters will be higher. Therefore, there are a large number of OEMs at present who are looking for partners in India. Right. The MRO market globally is a $43.2 billion industry, which is likely to grow to 65% by 2020, which is a slow growth. If it grows only at 4% or so, on an average. But you can see as far as India is concerned, there's a 10.3% growth in the aviation market. Because of the profit market. It's because the general aviation market, which I just said earlier, concerning of helicopters and the business jets, is going to be the next growth wave in India. And we expect 30 helicopters and 30 business jets to come into the country per annum. And therefore, in India, we feel that from today's $500 to $600 million spent is going to become a $1.6 billion spent in India. 2010, we are the topmost market. And as far as the last decade was concerned, we were number 3. Right. Another market, another opportunity, homeland security. Vast borders, terrorist problems, insurgency problems, and therefore large opportunities which are going to come in, and maybe later on when the defense market slows down, maybe after a decade or so, this is homeland security is going to keep going. So the budgets are increasing, whether it's the government budget, so between the government and the state concerned in India. The thrust areas are the software-related products, organizing of databases, methods of analyzing intelligence, internet surveillance, and of course, coastal security and sensors. UAVs will be required in a big way again. And that is the reason why, in fact,